drifting away. But we come still every day.
Involved with setting a balloon up?
You lay it on the ground sideways. You have a fan that puts cold air into it. Then we start the burner, which is also sideways. It sucks that cold air, and as that air becomes hot and wants to rise, the balloon sets up into its normal position.
How come the balloons don't burst into flames?
Well, the mouth is about 12 feet across, and the little flame is only about a foot in diameter with a lot of power and straightforward. It doesn't come anywhere in contact with the material.
Well, that keeps us up, really. That's just making the air hot again in the balloon. And as soon as we turn the burner off, the air is beginning to cool down. So we need to reheat the air in the balloon periodically to keep us buoyant.
This thing flies on the basis that hot air rises.
That's correct. The balloon is just like a cork floating. Instead of on the water, we're floating on the air.
How are we going to land?
When we decide to land, we won't burn as much, and we bring the balloon down level to the ground. Mm-hmm. And just as we make contact with the ground, I open a big valve in the top of the balloon and spill the air out.
The balloon basically comes in three parts. You've got your basket, your burner and its fuel, and the balloon or the envelope. Oh, and of course you've got the aeronaut and all his knowledge.
Time goes by. No time to cry.
In one word, how would you describe ballooning?
Magnificent.